It's Maria. She says, we have been together for 8 months. We love each other, but he just confessed he has an addiction to cocaine. Mm. I want to help him. He is currently working on getting help. It's something that I'm struggling with. Do I jump ship like my friends advised? Wow. Do you want to jump on this or should I?
You can start. I'll finish.
So here's the deal, guys. You know, it's interesting, the question. And my heart and mind goes to the person who asked the question. Because what I have found is that those that tend to attract these type of situations in their lives have a habit of doing so. Here you've been dating this person for 8 months. He can, and you love him, you care about him. He's confessed that he has a cocaine addiction. Now, I have so many questions about what he's doing about his cocaine addiction. How long has he been addicted to cocaine? Why is it that you're just now finding out that he's addicted to cocaine after 8 months? And so what does that mean for your future? Because we already know that how a thing begins really does have a, give you a great picture of how things are going to end. And, you know, there are four different types of personalities that we take on in life, okay? And there's only four, and we all fit into one of those roles, okay? Either you are going to be the perfect person, the brilliant person, or you're going to be the sick person who's always sick and needing some kind of support, or you're going to be the caregiver, or you're going to be the rebel. Now, these things play a part in everyone's life, in every family dynamic. You might actually be able to look into your own family and look at your own siblings and figure out, what role did I play in my household? Was I the rebel or was I the brilliant one? Was I the caregiver or was I the sick one? Because what happens is we figure it out early on in life that if I can play these roles, and you only can play the roles that are only that are available. So if you got one above you and they already took the sick role, you can't play sick. You got to do something else. If you'll discover that's how I get my attention. And what will happen if you don't heal that is that you will attract people, if you become the caregiver, who always need care. Okay? And it's interesting, caregivers are never attracted to other caregivers. Sick people are never always attracted to sick people because there's too much competition. You're more likely to have the brilliant person be with the rebel or the sick person be with the caregiver. And if you have found in your history that you're always attracting someone to be cared for, to be supported, some insurmountable task that you can't fix because you cannot fix someone else's addiction, then that is an indication that there's some deep work that you need to do.
Wow. That's powerful. Yeah. So I hope that you take heed to what she just said. Listen, you need to watch the replay and listen to what she just said. Take notes and process it. And to be honest, I would highly recommend you reach out to us. Like, you can set up a discovery call. Just go to the website, couplesacademy.org, set up a 15-minute discovery call so we could talk about your situation and guide you through a process. We've been working with individuals who have struggled with addictions. And, you know, it's a different reality in terms of what you'll deal with in your relationship than what someone else will. And so, listen, please reach out to us. We would love to talk with you and guide you through a process, particularly if you're talking about getting married at some point. These are the things that you need to be aware of. Yeah.